In this video, we are going to take a look at GoGuardian Teacher's new feature with student groups, where you can use and manage those with scenes. So we are now in an active class session where we have two students who are active online, and we are now going to be able to place those students each in their own scene using student groups, which is very exciting. We don't have to place the entire class in one scene or exclude anybody from our class session. There are two ways to do this with student groups, so we'll show both options. The first is to click the checkbox in the upper left corner. You'll now have an apply scene button in the teacher commands along the bottom, and you can choose an allow scene or a block scene from your dropdown, and it will automatically split your class into groups based on which students you clicked the checkbox for. So if you just selected one student like we did here, that student will be pulled into their own group with the scene applied. So you can see in that upper right corner, we have the No YouTube scene applied to group A for our test student. You can click on the settings gear next to the group name and you'll be able to edit those groups, including their names and which students are in them. And so that's your options over here. You can also name the activity. So this one's called Scene Groups. So you can save that group for the future by naming it. You can also apply a scene to the other group in that dropdown for group B. So you'll see we just applied the reading assessment scene for group B for that student in that group. You can move the groups, collapse those, change which ones are on top with the arrows. You can disable the scenes per group or overall for all groups. So you have those options. Then you can disable groups from the student group dropdown and it will return your class to that normal view where they are all together in one group. So again, selecting by the checkbox is one option, or you can create new groups from the student groups menu. So you can select the group name, you can give them a name that's only visible to the teacher, and then you can select which students by clicking the edit button next to the group and selecting the students that go in that group. You can create multiple groups for your class and differentiate the structure for your scenes that way. And then you can name that set of groups so you can reference it later for different activities. So now we have our groups that we set up using that student groups dropdown. And then we can apply the scenes for each group. So we have group A now working in for reading or ELA. They're doing a Lexia scene, and then No YouTube for group B. So maybe a little bit more structured for group A and just a block scene for group B. So you can also open tabs for the specific groups using that button, and you can also do the teacher commands for individual groups. And again, clicking that settings gear will let you edit those groups, including the group names. And then up at the top, if you click on the overall scenes, you'll see that you have two scenes applied. You can disable all of the scenes for the whole class from that dropdown, but to add a new scene, you do need to do that from each group. So you'll see you have a little message for no scene applied at the very top that you need to apply the scene per group. So individually groups, you can apply scenes now, and you can also again bring those groups, turn those on and off. We have both of the groups that we created during this video are saved automatically for future use in that student groups dropdown.